X-ray orthopantomography, or OPG, is a type of X-ray acquisition technique that is typically used for imaging teeth and the surrounding soft tissues in a single long, flat image. An OPG can also be used to detect mandibular fractures and other features surrounding the teeth. Here we see a typical OPG image of a patient with horizontally impacted lower wisdom teeth. Note that the mandibular structures and teeth are well defined, and the background features such as the skull largely have reduced clarity. This is made possible by the acquisition methods used in OPG. In order to understand how an OPG image is generated, we need to first understand a few parts of the classical X-ray tomographic imaging technique. Tomography is a technique that is used to selectively image a plane in a larger block of tissue. In tomographic imaging, an image is taken by projection as normal. While the imaging is being performed, both the X-ray camera and film or sensor move in opposite directions to each other at the same speed. We can get a better understanding of this by looking at how the image will be projected at one extreme, the center, and the other extreme. By moving both the camera and the film, only a single plane will remain in sharp focus, whereas contrast from above and below this plane will be blurred as its position will not be constant on the film. In order to select which plane we image, we can vary the speed of the film movement with respect to the camera. If we reduce the speed of the film, the imaging plane will shift closer to the film. If we instead increase the speed of the film, the plane will shift away from the film. When using this technique, it is also important to remember that as we shift the imaging plane away from the camera, the plane will increase in thickness, and to the contrary, decrease in thickness as we shift closer to the camera. OPG imaging takes advantage of these two effects in tomographic imaging, along with some other imaging techniques, in order to image a curved plane along the arch of the teeth. The X-ray camera and film are mounted on an arm that rotates around the approximate center of the arch of the teeth. The X-ray beam is collimated between 4 to 7 millimeters wide and projected through a slit to avoid blurring the image during rotation of the camera and film. In order to further reduce blurring, the film is also exposed through a slit. The film is also mounted on a drum or sliding mechanism, but the drum is more common. The drum rotates in the same direction as the arm as the imaging is performed. By mounting the film on a drum, its effective speed with respect to the camera can be modified by decreasing or increasing the speed of rotation. This change in rotation speed can thus be used to modify the plane currently being imaged, as only one point along the imaging path will match the current speed of the film past the slit, or other points along the imaging path will be blurred. In most systems, the rotation speed of the main arm remains constant. By varying the speed of the film drum, it is then possible to create an imaging plane that follows the shape of the dental arch. In order to better fit this arch, some manufacturers use a sliding center of rotation for the main arm that shifts between three points. The net result is a curved imaging plane that changes in width, as the plane will now vary in distance from the camera. Note that the imaging plane is now thinner at the front for the incisor teeth and thicker for the molars. This sort of plane is only possible by the combination of multiple axes of rotation and varying the film drum speed.